Link TV, connecting you to the world. Link TV is viewer supported. Watch more at linktv.org. In Iraq, security forces opened fire on protesters in Mosul City's Arar Square. In light of the events, the Nineveh Provincial Council suspended its official duties in the province for one day in protest of the security forces' attack on Mosul demonstrators.
In this video, people rising up are trying to reach Mosul's Akrar Square. Security forces prevented them from doing so and then opened fire on them with live bullets. There is no doubt that this video will be followed by others. Prime Minister Nouri al-Maliki was unexpectedly confronted on three different levels. These days, he comes from al-Mosul. These are stressful days for every ruler that finds himself surrounded by angry protesters calling for his downfall unless he meets a list of demands. Their first no is a firm objection to the Nineveh Provincial Council's nomination of a new police commander to the province, who protesters accuse of killing hundreds of Iraqis. The second no comes as a rejection to Nouri al-Maliki's invitation for a delegation of Mosul residents to meet with him. What is the purpose of such a meeting when their demands are as clear as the sun at 4 o'clock in the afternoon? The government in Baghdad is politically marginalizing Mosul and imposing its security mechanism on the city. Security forces arrest whomever they want and impose arbitrary rules on the people's movements to impede traffic in daily life. And this rejection is based on the martyrs.
Brothers, in your name and in the name of all honorable people, we reject this offer. We reject this offer. We say to al-Maliki, that those who want to talk to us can come to us. They can meet with us here in the square.
ثم رفض جماهيري ثالث ورسمي لحظر التجوال ومنع الاعتصام.
Then came an official rejection, in addition to that of the masses, to the curfew and the ban on demonstrations. But as soon as the curfew is imposed, the people take to the street en masse. Their actions are reciprocated, as if the issue is some sort of struggle to break the people's will and see who will last longer. An additional facet was added to the issue when security forces fired live bullets at protesters. The constitution allows the people of the country to stage sit-ins and protests, but then the land seems to be devoid of a constitution. Power is imposed on the people, telling them either you stay home silent or live bullets from above and probably to your heads is what you can expect. In reality, a number of Mosul residents were hit after security forces forcibly dispersed the protest. However, this has been tried and proven. As soon as people hear the sound of bullets, feelings of nationalism and revenge are born inside of them. Why are they killing us and depriving us of our rights? So the ruler replies in the end, how I wish I hadn't killed, and how I wish I had met their demands on the very first day.
This program is brought to you by Link TV for educational and non-commercial use only. Link TV is the only U.S. network dedicated to global and national news, uncompromising documentaries, and diverse cultural programs, programs which connect you to the world.